Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Hope you guys are doing well. So today we're talking about a topic that is highly requested time and time again. Whenever I do a live, whenever I look at my comment section, you guys want to know how to be confident and what does confidence mean to me. Now before I get into the video, part of being and feeling confident is smelling good. I don't know about you guys, but as I've been in quarantine, even if I spray myself a little bit of perfume, I feel so much better. I don't know, it just feels nice to smell nice. So today I am introducing you guys to Native. Native is a natural deodorant and is not harmful at all. It is aluminium free, sulfate free, and paraben free. I'm not kidding you guys, this is probably the only natural deodorant that actually works for me. And what I typically look for in a deodorant is smell, durability, and comfort. I apply Native once I've come out of the shower, swipe it about 2 to 3 times, and Bob's your uncle. These are not too dry and not too sticky either, and it doesn't leave any nasty residue. And I love it because when I wear it daily, the scent lasts all day. The smells are absolutely delicious. I have here the lavender and rose, the coconut and vanilla, and the cucumber and mint. My favorite is the coconut and vanilla because it reminds me of back home. These are super easy to transport, to slip into your bag, reapply, and feel fresh all over again. So all three deodorants are usually $36, but if you use my link and code, you'll get them for $24. That's a 33% discount. Plus you get free shipping. So click the link in my description box and try them out for yourself. So as I was saying, people always ask me how to be confident. Now I guess you're asking me because you see me as somebody that is quite confident. I'm not afraid to put myself out there. I'm not afraid to speak my mind. I'm not afraid to have some standards, and I'm not afraid to lose people. And people always ask me, have you always been confident? And I kind of say yes and no. From a young age, I didn't really let a lot of things get to me. But when I think about my confident years, like from I will say 13 and up, I can look back now and say that it was kind of a false sense of confidence. It was a shallow kind of confidence, which was just in my outside appearance. I was confident in the way that I looked, so therefore it was a kind of superficial confidence, and it was based on how much I was validated. My sense of self would go up and down depending on how much attention I could get. I guess the confidence that I kind of had was a kind of conceitedness. I legit remember when I was younger, I was going to get a tattoo on the back of my back saying conceited. Remember that song, I'm conceited, I got a reason? That's how conceited and how full of myself, or as I thought back then, confident I was with myself. Now that I'm older, I feel like I have a quiet confidence that manifests on the outside by how I carry myself, what I say, what I believe, what I think, and how I speak. And so here, let me kind of tell you guys what brings me confidence. I can only speak for myself. And so my first layer of confidence, based on who I believe I am, based on who I belong to. Just think for a second. If the richest, most noblest, most revered man on this planet was your father, how would you carry yourself? Well, somebody a million times more worthy than that is my father, the creator of the entire universe. I am the king's kid. I literally walk different with that knowledge. I don't feel inferior to anybody. My father, the creator of the universe, is my daddy. Father, he's literally my dad, and that's my belief, and that's what keeps me secure. When I believe in something that is immovable, unshakable, never changing, I can have confidence in that. If I was to base my first layer of confidence on things that were shifting and changing, I wouldn't be a confident person. I'd be up and down, up and down, up and down, because everything else in this world is changing, moving. So yeah, with that knowledge, I move different, I talk different, I pray different. And that's because I have a relationship with the Father by believing in the Son, and I don't think you can get any higher than that. So the first layer was faith in God, and my second layer is faith in myself. And that's really where we get the word confidence. Confidence, when you break it down, is literally just the faith in yourself, the belief in yourself. It's not enough to know that God believes in you. You must now believe in yourself. And that's what I want to focus more about in this video today. I know it's really, really cliche, just believe in yourself, but really it is the motor in your engine. It's what keeps everything going. Confidence is consistent. I mean, I'm talking about confidence, I'm talking about inner confidence, right? Because I'm going to talk about insecurities later. But the confidence, that security within yourself, it's really the motor in your engine that keeps you going and going and going. It's a thing that anchors you and keeps you firm no matter what. And it's like other people believing in you is fine, but you believing in yourself is where it's at. Because it really doesn't mean anything if everybody believes in you, but you don't believe in you. Nobody's belief in you can replace your belief in yourself. And so one of the things that really get in the way of us believing in ourselves is the knowledge of our own insecurities, our own insufficiency. But I also want you guys to know that you can be a confident person and still have insecurities. You can be confident in one area of your life and be incredibly insecure in another area, but that doesn't make you less of a person. I'll never profess to be 100% confident. I'm a work in progress, you're a work in progress, and that is perfectly fine. But just because you have insecurities, notice I said have and not are, because I believe that when you claim such titles, it can be very disempowering. But yes, just because I have insecurities, it doesn't have to stop me from being confident. And here's how. Confidence has a lot more to do with who you are and not who you think you're not. It is more empowering to affirm who you are than to affirm who you're not, or to focus on who you're not, which is what drives insecurities. It comes from a place of deficiency and not abundance. When you affirm this is who I am, it's empowering. Why focus on what you're not when you can focus on who you are? The power is in affirming who you are and not who you're not. And if you have watched my imposter syndrome video, I talked a lot about competence bringing confidence. When you invest in yourself, when you hone your skills, when you work on your weaknesses, you can have confidence in that competence. And so therefore you can have faith in the thing that you have invested in. I hope that makes sense. When you work on your area of lack or your weaknesses and invest in yourself, it brings a level of competence. And therefore you can have faith or confidence in your competence, even though you may not yet have confidence in yourself. So you're working on the areas that you're good at. Let's say you have a talent, right? So then you can put your confidence in that now, even though you may not have confidence right now in you. So yeah, make sure you check out that imposter syndrome video. So let me just say this. If you have the power to improve on your weaknesses or change the things that you're insecure about, then go ahead and do that, but do that from a safe place of love. However, I strongly believe that if you don't work on the belief that is driving the insecurity, you can change 1,000 things about you and still be deeply insecure. And I usually don't like talking about physical appearance on my channel because I really do think it's an internal issue that starts right here in the mind. So if you notice in my videos, I talk more about internal things than external things, because I think what you believe about yourself on the inside will manifest on the outside. It's always inside out. That's why I believe so much in soul surgery, maybe not as much in plastic surgery. So I feel like some women that go ahead and get surgery do so from a place of wanting to change how they feel about themselves, when in actuality it wasn't the feeling that brought the insecurity in the first place, it was the belief. Now this is kind of complex, but every time you watch my videos, understand this: there are layers to everything, and everything has roots, some very, very deep roots. But once you get to the level of the root, you're able to pluck it up with all of its manifestations. You understand that? If I planted onions in the ground, right, and I wanted to get rid of the onions, I wouldn't just pluck the onions off. I would have to uproot everything. And this is what I want to do in my soul surgery online course, which you need to sign up to ASAP. So for example, I can feel unlovable because deep down I believe I'm unlovable. I can feel socially awkward because deep down I believe I'm socially awkward. And so in return, that affects my actions, which then confirms what I feel about myself. Stop the video and rewind that and digest what I just said. My beliefs affect my feelings, which influence my actions. So if you believe wrong, you will live wrong. If you don't take anything away from anything I've ever said in all my videos, your beliefs influence your feelings, which influences your actions. In order to be able to deal with these things on a personal level, I have to be working closely with you so that I can actually help you to identify what those beliefs are and help break them down from the root upwards. I truly believe that all our insecurities are linked back to lies we believe about ourselves. So when said woman gets surgery, yes, she may look better or she may be affirmed more by people, but if that inner belief hasn't changed, she's still going to have a level of insecurity. And therefore she wasted the money at the doctors that she should have spent on therapy or my course. So how can I help you today, ladies, to feel more confident? Here's a tip. I want you to start thinking, not feeling, I want you to start thinking more positively about the things that you dislike about yourself. But not only that, I want most of your energy, most of your positive energy to be spent on focusing on the things that you do like about yourself. And you may be sitting there thinking, there's nothing that I like, everything is wrong, I hate everything, I hate my face, I hate the way I talk, I hate my voice, I hate my hair, I hate my feet, I hate my toenails. No, there's something about you that you like. There's something about you that people compliment you on. And we all know that positive energy is more effective than negative energy. Studies have shown when students speak life to a plant, it grows. But when students spoke negative and damning words to the plant, it actually shriveled up and didn't grow. So if that happens to a plant, can you imagine what happens to us? And sometimes we are our own worst enemy. Our self-talk is our biggest enemy. And I'm gonna be talking about self-talk in my video next week. So I wanna encourage you ladies, you can be confident. You can learn to love the difficult parts of you, and you can believe in yourself. It's going to take time, but you're going to have to become attentive to your thoughts. And if you take away anything in this video, this week, I want you to be attentive to the things that you're thinking. So if you suffer with bad insecurities, I want you to take a notepad this week, and every time you have a negative thought, write it down. So then on my video that's coming up next week, obviously watch that video, but then I want you guys to list the things that you wrote about yourself. I really want to hear some of the things that you guys truly believe about yourself. So keep a journal this week. Anytime you have a negative thought, don't think about how can I change this thought, just write it down. I want to hear from you guys. When I know the beliefs that you guys are believing, I'll be able to work more specifically and make videos more direct to the beliefs that you're believing. Okay guys, I hope you guys enjoy this lovely weather. The weather is beautiful. I am honestly melting like a chocolate bar in this car. I came out here and I wanted to make this video. I spent hours trying to get this film right, but I wanted to make this video because I know it's going to help transform and change somebody's mind. So I hope you guys like this video. Please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe. We're nearly at 400,000. What? If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe. Share with your friends. Tell everybody the good news. And yeah, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.